morning, everyone. Hello, Sheppy. Can you say hi to the people? He doesn't like to be filmed by him on his own. It's okay if I'm with him and we're snuggling. We have some of our Christmas rules here. Spread Christmas cheer. We definitely believe in Santa Claus. Share your toys. Don't get your tinsel in a tangle. There's a lot of really cute ones. Be kind and of good cheer. All hearts come home for Christmas. So even if you can't go home, or the ones you love can't come home to yours for Christmas, their hearts will be there. Our hearts will be there. And here's a beautiful fox that I picked up in Innistimon. Isn't she beautiful? By Fiona Concannon. So remind me of our beautiful Foxy, and of course Skittles and the one-eyed fox and all the others that are around. So that's just resting up there while the Christmas rules are hanging up. But I just hear Tom coming in. He's gone to the shops just to get me a few things because I'm getting ready to bake something different I haven't done before. Again, out of Nigel Slater's Christmas Chronicles, but I'm going to make the fig and orange shortbreads. And that's what his look like. I can tell you what, mine probably aren't going to look like that. But Tom loves shortbread, hence I'm making him the shortbread Christmas socks. And I'll give you an update of those. But let's open day 18 now. I'll go get it. Just wanted to quickly show you. I don't usually show the windows I opened because they're just pictures and it takes a long time. But today I got a gnome, which made me very excited because this came in the post yesterday. A gnome's Christmas. So maybe we'll look through that on one of the Vlogmas days. Not today because I have too much film. But, so let's open. Let's light the candle and open day 18. Day 18. Giving yourself permission to treat yourself. Because we often are busy treating the ones in our life and not necessarily ourselves. So let's treat each other and ourselves. So, day 8. I'm in a new position today because all the baking things are behind me. So, ooh, look. These are some of my favorite colors. Oh, I love reds. What am I talking about? I love pretty much all the colors, the vibrant and rich colors particularly. Okay, after the chimney. Okay, after the chimney. So we had been up on the chimney, and then after the chimney, that's what he does. He pops down. Down came the chimney, St. Nicholas with the bound, and there he is in his outfit. Looking very coordinated with my beautiful yarn. I would love to have a big full skein of that. That is lovely. And let me just tell you quickly, this is the Robin's Promise yarn. She's a dyer in Williamsburg, Virginia, and she based her advent calendar on this book, illustrated by Florence Sarah Winship, 1969 version of The Night Before Christmas, because it was a childhood book for her, and it is for me, as you can tell by my name being written in it. So super duper special. Let's hang up day 18. So there's day 18 with its friends hanging in front of all the garlic we have drying. Isn't that gorgeous? I'm gonna do some really big blanket or an actual blanket to be cozy and warm in with these beautiful colors. And you can follow the progress of the book in the run of the colors. And I'm super duper excited to start knitting on that once I get them all up. Yeah, I think I will make the decision of how exactly I'm going to do that and then have that as my Christmas cast on. Yay! So here are my different ingredients for the orange and fig shortbread. Sprinkle, top it off with some rose petals and some icing sugar. So I am under no illusion that mine are going to look nearly as nice as Nigel's, but so I'll do a little speedy uppy thing probably so you can see some of what I'm doing and you can see the finished product. It's not the most attractive thing at the minute, but it'll be yummy. Thank you. almond flour. This is Dawn's dates. She's got, maybe that's in the way, I don't know. She's got these little quick homemade gift ideas. She has a tutorial blog for someone in your life that did sewing or, you know, button collectors, that kind of thing. So if you need something quick, check that out. Something quick for a crafty person in your life or a collector. Those little jars are really cute for keeping bits and bobs in, shells or whatever. Oh, the smell of the oranges. Oh, my goodness. Oh, people, you can get a little bit of the smell. Oh, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. I wish you could all come around and I could share them. I wish I could post them all out, but then I would be baking for many, many moons, and I don't want to do that. So my handy-dandy dishwasher, Tom, he will clean that up for me because he's so sweet. Yeah, and we'll see how close I get him to look like that. The oven is chirping.
Me.
Oh yeah, I think they're done. Ooh, they smell good.
Yeah.
I've never made shortbread before, so this is totally new. Ooh. Well, I'm really pleased to say, I mean, they aren't as fancy looking as Nigel's, but I'm really happy with the way they look. And I've had a little nibble of that one, and they're yummy. So this is the fig and orange shortbread from Nigel Slater's book, The Christmas Chronicles. In the middle is that fig, and orange paste. So really yummy. Hooray! So I recommend that recipe as well. It was pretty easy to make. If you have like the food processor, it's probably easier. Probably the most fiddly part would have been mixing up the golden sultanas and the figs. If you kind of had to, you know, chop them all up and try to make a paste out of them without some sort of electrical appliance. But if you have something like that, I'd say it's pretty easy and it's yummy. Okay, before we sign off, I'll give you a little update on the saga of Tom's sock. So he wore the sock all day yesterday and he absolutely loves the fit and loves the idea of having the handmade sock, because I was excited to make that for him. And this is where his sock, actually his regular socks, wear out under his foot. So he can just feel that as like a sort of a rough texture. And this is just regular superwash merino. So it's not something I can just fix by saying, oh, well, that's because I have a rough wool. But he just feels that if he's walking, he's feeling that if he walks for an extended time, like if he goes for, you know, a walk, that it might rub his feet or irritate them. But he wants to, you know, definitely to finish the second pair, because they're his Christmas shortbread socks, and to wear them, you know, around the house or if he's not going too far. But what I'm going to do, and I would really love if you have any suggestions, is I'm gonna knit this here on the regular, my regular 2.25s,
But maybe I will just jump up once I finish the heel to 2.5. Gauge won't be as tight. Maybe that will make a difference. Like, maybe it won't feel so sort of rough, you know. I mean, sometimes, you know, the tighter gauge feels stiffer. So we're going to try that. It's just an experiment. But, you know, we won't really know till we try. So that is the saga of Tom's sock, continuing saga. I've just done the cuff here. So just had to add in here, Tom said it's the saga, not the sock saga. This is the shortbread Christmas cast on last year from Giddy Aunt Yarns, the shortbread sock set. So that's the update on the sock, and we'll let you know how it goes. And if you have any tips for that, let me know. Really appreciate it. Okay, happy holidays, everyone. Happy Vlogmas, and we will see you in tomorrow or the next day.